بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على خير خلق الله أجمعين محمد بن عبد الله الصادق الأمين. My brothers and sisters, every single one of us goes through our own trials and tribulations. Illnesses occur every single day, whether ourselves or our families, our loved ones. And we rush to the doctors and we rush to the medical centers and the hospitals, and we rush to the mashayikh and the du'at. Every single one of them, we're in search of them giving us a cure. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved us so much effort if we follow one thing that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam accepted us for us to do. And that is found in a story narrated by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri. When one day he narrates that one day he was walking with his companions and they came across a town, a village in Arabia. And they went inside and asking for them for some help. They wanted to drink some water, they wanted to drink some milk and eat something, for they're traveling in the desert and the heat and they were all tired. And when they asked for them to feed them or to give them any kind of sustenance, the villagers said, "We can't, for our village elder has been stung by a scorpion or has been stung by any other insect and he's feeling ill. So is there anyone amongst you that could give us something to heal this person? Does anyone amongst you have anything to read upon this person that he may be cured?" So he said, one of our companions said, "I do." And so he went with the young lady and he went to the village elder and he recited upon him. And he kept on reciting until this elder became better. And when coming back, all the villagers were happy, the village people were happy. And they said to Abu Sa'id al-Khudri and his companions, "Thank you very much. And here, take some of the sheep." And so they gave them about 30 of the sheep. And they said, "What did you do? What did you read?" He said, "By Allah, I only read Fatihatul Kitab. I only read Al-Fatiha." And they said, "And he was okay?" He said, "Yes." "And this is all that they gave us?" "Yes." And so they said, "Don't take anything of it. We need to go back to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to make sure that what you did was actually acceptable in Islam." And so when they came back to Medina, they rushed to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they told him the story. And then Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam turned to this young man and he said, "And who told you that Al-Fatiha cures?" Asking the question to say that you were correct in what you did. But where did you get this knowledge from? Agreeing with him that what he did by reading Surah Al-Fatiha cured this elder from this stung, from the sting of the scorpion. And here Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam then told his companions, "Go and do as you wish with what they have given you as gifts and give me a share of it also." My brothers and my sisters, this is proof for us that yes, when we do go in search of a cure for our sick and for those who are in pain, we can start off by our first following one of the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We can start reading a Surah Al-Fatiha as a type of ruqya, where we place our hand, as mentioned by some of the scholars, we place our hand on top of where is the pain, and inshaAllah, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the pain will go away with Surah Al-Fatiha. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cure our hearts and our bodies with the Quran, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you all. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Albayan Radio, the voice of Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah.